You know, when you first started out, I like to ask this question because most musicians give me the same answer because it's kind of cool. When you first started out playing, as you went on, did you have any doubts when you started that you would be successful? Like, did you even think about it?
You know, no, because I knew I would be. Doesn't that sound very egotistical? As a child, I just knew. That's,
all right.
I think that's the beauty of being a child, though, is that when you're young enough, if you had very positive parents that really support you, like I was fortunate enough to have, no is not an answer. An option, really. I would see myself, when I was very young, my mom would take me to the symphony, because I was studying European classical music then, and we would sit at Ford Auditorium in Detroit back then, which used to be the home of the symphony, and I'd sit and I'd watch the soloists come out, and I would say, one day that's going to be me standing there, and I didn't know how, but it was just such a passion and such a drive that it just, in my mind, it just had to be, and there was no other option, no other answer. This is what I had to do.
There it was, and here you are.
Yeah.
Up until now, and I'm not, I know this is a strange question, but what do you consider to be your finest musical achievement?
I don't feel like I've gotten there yet.
Okay.
Right. And that's the beauty of the music, is I think you never feel that way, or at least I don't. I feel like I try, and with each, especially with recording records, I feel like it documents where I was at that point in time. And then I'm like striving to be better and hoping that the next record or the next gig or the next stuff that I'll be even better. But I'm never satisfied.
All right. Your opinion of the word jazz.
I'm sorry?
Your opinion of the word jazz.
Of the word itself?
Mm-hmm.
You know, I usually say, I like to think of it as American classical music.
I hear you.
America's classical music. So I know what it means, but I know so many times that people who don't play the music or who are not fans of the music necessarily tend to look at it as a lesser music, especially if you compare it to European classical music. So I really prefer... and depending on who I'm speaking with, American classical music. Because it is a classical music.
It is that. Are you still teaching?
I don't teach on a regular basis. I do master classes or clinics with children when I'm traveling. So whomever might want to have me come in and do something, I go in and work with string students. And I enjoy that, but I don't teach on a regular basis.
So what would you give, our last question would be, what advice would you give up-and-coming artists?
I have to laugh at myself because I think, oh, it's so difficult out here now with the economy and blah, blah, blah. But it's always difficult, and it's always
right.
Tough, you know. So, you know, I would just say to young people to, of course, work hard at their craft and really be better than better, constantly work on it, and really to concentrate on writing as well, composing, because that's another avenue, another income avenue, which is important, other than playing, you know, to really stress that, because there's work and arranging and composing, film scoring, the possibilities are endless.
Endless. They are. Regina, I want to thank you so much for being here with us. I really feel good about it because you're one of my favorite entertainers and musicians. I love your music.
Thank you.
You exude with such calmness, and you can feel you know. So I want to thank you again, and here at the Jazz Intersection, I'm pretty sure that everyone will be waiting to hear the interview. And I wish you the best.
Thank you so much. Thanks for having me on.
It is my pleasure, and I look forward to seeing you sometime. Hopefully I can talk to you maybe about getting you here to Hawaii. You've been here before, of course.
One time only, so gotta get back.
Okay, all right. Again, we want to thank you.